4 years ago today, Chris Cornell sadly took his own life, and I felt like it'd be a good way to honor him by reacting to one of his songs. And it took me a bit to find what song to react to, because I know all of Temple of the Dog, I know almost all of Soundgarden, I know the first album for Audioslave, but then I remembered they have a second album, so today I'm gonna react to Be Yourself from Audioslave's second album. I forget exactly what it's called, I should check that. It's called Out of Exile, and this is one of the big songs from it. Just looking at the title, I'm like, I feel like this one will be a good one to react to, and I have the video up here. It's probably gonna get blocked knowing how stuff works on YouTube, and I was gonna listen to it live, but I feel like for this I should listen to it because it says album version here and it's closed caption. I don't know if you guys will see the lyrics and the captions and stuff, but I know I will here on YouTube. Without further ado, I mean, Chris Cornell is my favorite singer of all time. There is no question about it. I think he has the best voice in all of rock and music. That's just my opinion, and I can't wait to hear this song. Let's do this. Great bass line too. Drums with one hand.
Someone falls to pieces, sleeping all alone.
Oh, Jesus. Phenomenal.
Someone found salvation in everyone. Another only pain.
I just realized his ears were pierced. I love this. I don't want to talk over it, like. The high notes, too. Wow. That's very Rage Against the Machine type thing. It's obviously, if you know. This is insane. Wow. Whoa. Good message. The high notes too. Chills and goosebumps all over my body. You can't really see, but oh, he really was the best to ever do it. And like, I'm not kidding, I think Chris Cornell was the greatest singer, like at least rock singer for sure, of all time. I'm gonna again look up the meaning as always, because like I totally understand the meaning, but I want to see if it was like, if it was taken from some like situation or something. I can't speak. This is good. This is basically what I said, but it's more descriptive. It says, this song is about how everyone is different and how two people can react differently to the same events. Some find salvation, everyone another, only pain. Wow, that's a hard-hitting line. In an interview with Launch Radio Networks, Chris Cornell said, the be yourself part really just came from a lot of the things I've gone through in my life, and a lot of different changes, and all the different tragedies, and all the horrendously stupid mistakes I've made in my personal life, and wanting to be able to make up for those things, and wanting to be able to not be ashamed of all that stuff. You know, that's the one thing about getting older that's better, and this song kind of says it so simply, to agree that 10 years ago I would have been so embarrassed to put in a song, because it is so simple. But there it is, and then it just says, Francis Lawrence directed the video, which is modeled after the Beatles documentary film Let It Be. Lawrence has also directed videos for Aerosmith, Jennifer Lopez, and Gwen Stefani, and the song was featured in television show Scrubs on the episode Mirror Image. That's not really important, but I'll still say it anyway. I can, like, feel it. When I reacted to Nothing Compares to You, like, back in, I think, January it was, like, I had the same feeling of just impact, and maybe it is also because, you know, knowing that Chris Cornell isn't here anymore is an awful thing, and yeah, God. I don't normally, like, get emotional in videos, like, not to a certain degree, but there's something about his music that just is a whole other story, and, I mean, Audio Slave is a great band. Like, talking about the music, especially, I mean, Chris Cornell's singing is obviously fantastic, and I love the simplicity of the lyrics, straight to the point, you really get it. But talking about the music, obviously, this is Chris Cornell with the members, or at least some of the members of Killing in the Name, Rage Against the Machine. The song Killing in the Name, though, I don't think I've heard. Like, I know it's one of the most famous songs, and maybe I'll recognize it, but I am going to do a reaction to it, because I don't think I've actually heard it fully, and I know Bulls on Parade, so when it went to, like, that solo kind of thing, where it was like, vroom, 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 I was like, that's very Bulls on Parade, Rage Against the Machine type thing. Like, I know their sound, and I couldn't name a ton of the songs, but for the ones I've heard, I've really loved, so I will do a reaction to Killing the Name first. And that surprised me, and even, like, the bass, normally, like, bass for me, and for, I feel like for a lot of people, it's kind of more buried in the background, and sometimes it's kind of, yeah, pushed over to the side when it just plays the same as the guitar and it's quieter, but here it was like a strict bass line. I totally understood it, and it was really great. Oh, this song, yeah, really simple, straight to the point, but still really effective, and that's proof that you have a really great song on your hands. But what do you think of this song? What's your favorite Audioslave song? Tell me in the comments down below. For me, it'd probably be Show Me How to Live. I mean, I know it's one of the big ones, that one, or Like a Stone. They're just, the vocals on there are absolutely insane. And thank you all for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Over and out.